Now we come to our next topic. It will be your particular integral, how to obtain particular integrals. Earlier we have studied how to find complementary function and hence general solution when the right hand side member is zero. Now see, for this we need to study about the operator. See what is the operator? The d by dx. D by dx is written as capital D. It is just the operator. So dy by dx means d capital dy. It is written here dy by dx will be capital dy. And so d2 by dx2 will be capital D2, and d3 by dx3 will be capital D3, and so on. So d2y by dx2 will be capital D2y, and d3y by dx3 will be capital D3y, and so on. Similarly, 1 by d, or it is d to the power minus 1 d inverse. Actually, it is not power minus 1. It is 1 by d is the operator. D is differential operator, but 1 by d is integration operator. And 1 by d2 is integrate twice with respect to x. So now see, there are some properties of d which is very clear from its definition itself. See, du plus v will be du plus dv, distributive law, no doubt, since d is your d by dx. D plus au will be du plus au, and it can be written as a plus du. Dau is equal to adu. Dm, d to the power n, d to the power n, u is equal to d to the power m plus n, u. D plus alpha, d plus beta u can be written as d plus beta, d plus alpha u. So it is a material whether you differentiate first with respect to d plus alpha and differentiate further with respect to d plus alpha or with respect to d plus beta. Both will be same. Now see, they come particular integral when right hand side member is a function of x, not zero. See here, the general differential equation of linear differential equation of higher order with constant coefficients. Dn y by dxn plus p1 dn minus 1 by dxn minus 1 plus p2 dn minus 2y by dxn minus 2 plus 1 plus pn y is equal to this capital X. Earlier it was 0, but now we will take it non-zero. In symbolic form, we can write it as capital Dn p1 dn minus 1 plus p2 dn minus 2 plus 1 plus pn y is equal to capital X, or precisely fdy is equal to x, where fd is your this function. So that this is the operator now. Now this fd is operating on y, and therefore fdy is your x. Now the expression 1 upon fd x, it will be used to denote a function of x which does not involve arbitrary constant. So its particular integral of this equation will be 1 upon fd x. It will be clear with an example. Suppose, see here, when fd is equal to 1 upon dx will mean a function of x obtained by integrating x. See here, 1 upon dx cube means integrate x cube with respect to x. So it will be x to the power 4 by 4. 1 upon d2x square means integrate x square with respect to x twice. So it will be 1 upon dx cube by 3. This is equal to 1 upon 3 into x to the power 4 by 4. 1 upon d1 means integrate 1 with respect to x. So it will be x. With an example, this concept becomes very clear. See here, method of finding particular integral. Suppose the differential equation is expressed in this form, fdy is equal to x. So 1 upon fdx will be your particular integral. And this x, we can find the particular integral when this x is any one of these forms or some or sum of these forms. See what are the forms of x, the possible forms of x. X can be equal to e to the power ax, or it is sin ax or cos ax, or it is x to the power m, where m is a positive integer, or it is e to the power ax into v, where v is any function of x, or it is x to the power m into v, where v is any function of x. Now we will see one by one to find the particular integral when x is any one of these forms. First, to find the PI when x is equal to e to the power ax. See, when fdy is equal to e to the power ax, then the particular integral will be 1 upon fd e to the power ax. this can be written as e to the power x by fa, provided this fa is non-zero. Directly, you just remember this formula. It will be used frequently in your examination. So this f, when fa is non-zero, then 1 upon fd e to the power x will be e to the power x by fa. Simply replace d, this d by a. Replace d by a. See one example. When fa is equal, there we will find a situation when fa is equal to 0. That will be clear after some steps. See here one example. D2y by dx2 plus 3dy by dx plus 2y is equal to e to the power 2x. It is a linear differential equation of order 2 with constant coefficients. See here the auxiliary equation will be m square plus 3m plus 2 equal to 0. So this can be factorized as m plus 1, m plus 2 equal to 0. So m will be minus 1, minus 2. Therefore, the complementary function will be a into e to the power minus 1x plus b into e to the power minus 2x. This is our complementary function. But since here right hand side member capital X is not equal to 0, it is e to the power 2x. So we will have particular integral also. So this equation can be written as d2 plus 3d plus 2y is equal to e to the power 2x. Therefore, particular integral will be 1 upon d2 plus 3d plus 2 of e to the power 2x. See? So pi is given by 1 upon d2 plus 3d plus 2 e to the power 2x. We just need to replace this d by 2, provided this denominator is non-zero. So this is equal to 1 upon 2 square plus 3 into 2 plus 2. So it is equal to 2 to the 4 plus 6, 10 plus 2, 12. It means it is 1 by 12. E to the power 2x. And the general solution is y is equal to this complementary function plus particular integral. So y is equal to a into e to the power minus x plus b into e to the power minus 2x plus 1 upon 12 e to the power 2x. So this is our general solution. There are some exercise for you. You can solve them. They are very easy. Answers are also given here. Now see another type of particular integral. When x is your right sine x or cos x, it means right hand side is either sine x or it is cos x. There are some basic results. D2 sine x is equal to minus a square sine x, means differentiate the sine x twice. Similarly, differentiate again twice, so it will be minus a square whole square sine x, and D2 whole power and sine x will be minus a square whole power and sine x, and so on. So here the particular integral for fdy is equal to sin x or cos x will be 1 upon fd sin x or 1 upon fd cos x. See what will be the form of a particular integral. So this is equal to 1 upon 5d square sin x or 1 upon 5d square cos x if fd is your 5d square. We will replace this d square by minus a square, not minus a whole square. Minus times a square, replace this d square by. So it will be 1 upon 5 minus a square sin x or 1 upon 5 minus a square cos x. In case fd does not contain d square, d4 or d power 6, etc., then it will be clear with some examples also. See here, one example, d2y by dx2 plus y is equal to sin 2x. See here, the right hand side member is sin x type. Here the auxiliary equation will be m square plus 1 equal to 0. So m square is equal to minus 1. It means m is your plus minus I, means plus minus under root minus 1. Under root minus 1 is minus I. So m is plus minus I. Now therefore the complex number will be a cos x plus b sin x. Since alpha is 0 and beta is 1, so it is a cos x plus b sin x. Now from the given equation, d2 plus 1 y is equal to sin 2x, means from this one, particular integral will be 1 upon d2 plus 1 sin 2x. Now we will replace this d square by minus 2 square, since 2 is here with 2x. So it is 1 upon minus 2 square plus 1 sin 2x. It means it is minus 1 by 3 sin 2x. This is our particular integral. So the general solution will be y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. It means y is equal to a cos x plus b sin x minus 1 upon 3 sin 2x. Similarly, there is one more example. See, d2y by dx2 plus dy by dx plus y is equal to sin 2x. The auxiliary equation will be m square plus m minus 1 is equal to 0. From this, the value of m will be minus 1 plus minus root 1 minus 4 by 2. It is very easy. B square minus 4ac by 2a. Use the formula. So it is 1 plus minus root 3i by 2. It means 1 upon 2 plus minus root 3 by 2i. Now, this is our alpha is your 1 and beta is your 3 by 2. So this complementary function will be e to the power minus alpha by 2 x. So minus alpha x. So it is e to the power minus x by 2 into within bracket a cos beta x means root 3 by 2 x plus b sin beta x means root 3 by 2 x. So this is our complementary function. Now for particular integral, it will be 1 upon d square plus d plus 1 sin 2 x. See here. Replace d square by minus 2 square. So it will be 1 upon minus 4 plus d plus 1 sin 2 x. It means 1 upon d minus 3 sin 2 x. Now multiply numerator by d plus 3 and denominator by d plus 3. So that it is equal to d plus 3 by t square minus 9 sin 2 x. Now d square is again replaced by minus 2 square. So it is minus 4. It means it is equal to d plus 3 by minus 4 minus 9 sin 2 x. It means minus 1 upon 13 d plus 3 sin 2 x. Now this is equal to minus 1 upon 13. D is operating on sin 2x, d sin 2x plus 3 sin 2x. It is equal to minus 1 upon 13. D sin 2x means 2 cos 2x plus 3 sin 2x. Now this is our particular integral. Therefore, the complete solution will be y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. Now this is our complete solution or general solution. So this is all about for today's class. There are two examples. Solve them. And if you have any query or any difficulty, you can call me, WhatsApp me or email me. Also, this lecture will be available on YouTube. You see the lectures on YouTube and subscribe it for further coming lectures on YouTube.